Good afternoon to everyone. Welcome to the webinar session on Diwali recommendations on Diwali seller preparation. I know like there are very few days or very few weeks remaining for the sale to start. And the first question that I'm expecting from this group is ki, when is the event? Like what are the dates of the event? So let me try and clear somewhere around it. So to be honest, even we don't know as of now, the official dates are not yet out. But we are expecting it to start somewhere in the first 10 days of October is what we are expecting. But again, the construct of the event, the team is still evaluating how many phases and all, and we don't have a clarity as of now. Event dates, we are expecting to be officially told to everybody like very soon, maybe by this weekend or next week early. So we would rather, having said that, we'll have very 2 to 3 weeks left in hand as of now for the preparation. So we thought it would be good to reach out to all of you on how you can prepare better for the event, what all categories that you can focus on, what are the spikes that you are expect, and how much is the inventory that you should plan accordingly, right? Since historically Diwali sale has been the biggest sale event for the year, and this year also we expect a multifold increase in the customer visits as compared to the other events and the non-event days as well, right? So we already had first part of this webinar on Monday, where we covered the 4 categories, which was home, lawn and garden, business, industrial and automotive. Today we are going to cover the next 4, which are big ones, which is kitchen, home improvement, sports and furniture, right? So let's start with furniture first. Malvika, can you just go to next slide, please? Yeah, next slide. Next. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, Garima, please go on.
Thanks, Rishikesh. Hi, everyone. Today we'll be discussing how the furniture category per se has been performing. I'll quickly take you through the performance, what has been the performance for the first half of the year, and what kind of trends we are expecting for Diwali, and what are the specific product types or trends to look out for and prepare for different product types of furniture. Quickly highlighting the overall growth that we have been seeing on furniture year and year. Pre-lockdown and we compare it versus the post-COVID time period, we have seen almost a 116% growth in furniture, which clearly highlights the shift in the consumer behavior, and the spikes that we are expecting during Diwali would also be in line with the shift in the consumer behavior of buying furniture online. Quickly taking you through the different rooms and the different product types and what are the spikes that we will be expecting through each one of them. The first and the foremost, the biggest category that we have in furniture is the mattress. Growth has been almost around 150% year on year, and we have seen a lot of growth happening across all product types in mattress. We have primarily 4 types of mattress, primarily starting from the cotton mattresses, which are the traditional gaddas, what we call. Moving on to the memory foam mattress, which are right now come in roll pack mattress in a box. We have spring mattress, and then we have different material types like coir, latex also coming up in the market. Around 70% of the business right now lies with the memory foam roll pack mattresses, which we have, holds the majority share in the market. In that particular segment, the product types or the dimensions which sell the most are the king and the queen, which primarily operates in the range of around 9,000 to 12,000 range. So that would be the best optimal price point to operate at for this kind of selection. For spring mattress and coir mattress, these are a little more expensive, and around 15 to 20 is the price range for this kind of mattress. So when you are kind of listing your selection and deciding the price point for different product types, that would be the price range to keep in mind, so that you are attractive priced against the different competition that you have, and your products also are benchmark worst cases the different price ranges that we operate at for different product types. For this particular product category, we are expecting a spike of as high as 12x. This is in line with the growth that we have seen across different events throughout the year, and also the growth trajectory that this category has seen. So this would be a good opportunity for you to work on and list your selection and work on the price point in order to ride on the spike that we're expecting in this category. Can we have the next slide? Thank you. Moving on to the other part of the bedroom, which is the bed segment. This segment has seen a growth of around 130% year on year. And primarily the growth has been driven by two material types per se, which is engineered wood and solid wood. We have seen a trend of high search volumes being there for solid wood beds. So that is a new trend which we have seen, and a lot of brands have started listing their selection in this material type bucket, and we have seen growth also happening in this bucket. Engineered wood is the material type product segment where the maximum growth exists, and the maximum market share for beds exist in that particular segment, and mostly the price range where we operate for this product type is around 7,000 to 10,000. For the beds, we are expecting a spike during Diwali of around 9 to 10x. The price ranges which have been mentioned on the slide, these are the price ranges in which the product should be optimally priced to benefit from the how the other competitions are pricing their products and how we have seen the trend for the category for different product types. And we can move to the next slide. Moving on to the next big segment, and this segment is something which we have seen growing really fast from last 1.5 years. This is a new phenomena because a lot of people have started working from home, and the demand for office chairs, laptop tables and desks has grown by multifolds in last 1.5 years, and this category has seen a growth of around 170% year on year as compared to previous years. For the entire office furniture category, be it office chairs, laptop tables and study desks, we are looking at a spike of around 8 to 10x across different product types. A few of the trends probably if we have to look at. In office chairs, we are seeing a rise in the high back chairs and the gaming chairs per se, which are operate at a slight higher price point. A lot of customers have started searching and looking out for that kind of products. So that would be a good opportunity in case you have some selection across that bucket. Apart from that, the normal low back mesh chairs, which operate at the price point of around 25K to 4K, these have been traditionally the highest selling selection which we have across different brands. So these two would be a good mix of assortment that we can look at leveraging during the Diwali time period. Laptop tables traditionally have been selling high, and we have seen a spike in this segment post the COVID lockdowns came into existence. So we are expecting a 10x upward spike in this. Again, the price point plays a very important role because this is a very competitive category, and we have a lot of branded and non-branded selection operating in this. So in terms of the price point that you will be operating has to be very competitive so that your selection gets highlighted to the customer, as well as it's lucrative enough for the customer to select. In terms of the study desks, again, similar to what I had highlighted during in beds, we are seeing a spike in the solid wood category for this segment, which operates in the range of around 7 to 15K, and a little bigger tables is something which the customers have been looking for in shisham wood and mango wood. So that would be a good bucket to kind of play and basically have your selection in that price bracket and in that segment. go to next. I'll take you through one thing after at the end of the slides. We can go to the next slide. Yeah, so coming to the third most important category, which where you have a lot of subcategories playing in and where a maximum selection from majority of the sellers sit in, which is the living room, where we have sofas, recliners, TV units, sofa cum beds, ottomans, these kind of product types sitting in this. So this is the biggest category in size, if we have to say. And this has also seen a spike, not as high as probably in office furniture, but this is also growing at a rate of around 90% year on year. We have seen spikes in specific subcategories like recliners and sofas in last few events. As it's mentioned that we have seen during Prime Day, we had seen a spike of around 5x in the entire living room, the spike being higher on the recliners and sofas. So those are the categories to look out for. In recliners, single seater recliners and two seater recliners is something which have been like really searched, and the search volumes are quite high for these product types. Specifically for single seater recliner, the price point becomes very important, because this is a segment where the different brands are very competitive, and the entry price point is as low as 9999. So we have to be very cautious in terms of where we place our products and what kind of material type the product is. Based on that, we do the pricing, because this is a very competitive product type to operate in. But definitely, if you have the right pricing and the for the right product type, this is a segment where you can grow maximum. So accordingly, look at the price point at which you'll be operating and then list the selection accordingly. Some of the other products which we have been going faster are the sofa sets, which is 3+2+1 or 3+2+2 sizes, which have seen the maximum growth in from last Diwali onwards. And these are the custom, because this is a design heavy category sofas, so customers look for new unique designs. So this is an opportunity for you to play in terms of looking at the different unique designs that you can operate at, and accordingly look at the price range at which these different product types are available, and accordingly list your selection, which will help you give an advantage of uniqueness as well as operating at a best price point for the category. So this was in nutshell some of the trends that we have seen in different rooms and product types. But one thing, like as we enter into Diwali season, which I want to highlight specifically for furniture, to across your entire selection, which you should be looking at and kind of preparing yourself, is to look at how you have listed your selection, the new selection which you are listing, as well as the selection which is already listed, in terms of what are the attributes that have been filled in. Is the title correct? Look at, there are some style guides which are there on the Seller Central. So look at if the title is right, you have put the right images for the customers to look at. You're providing all the attributes right. How this helps you in terms of your business is that when a customer searches something, if all these things are right for you, it helps your selection to come up in the search results. So if you are right on all these things, the chances of your selection coming up for the customer in the search results are higher. So these are the important things probably which you can look at, apart from the other marketing initiatives and pricing initiatives that you'll be looking at to prepare yourself for Diwali. I'll take a pause here and hand it over to the next speaker. I'll take up the questions and answer to each one of the questions that you have. Thank you, everyone.
Hi. Thanks for this. Now we'll start with kitchen. Before we start, I'd just like to let the audience know about what kitchen comprises of in Amazon. Kitchen basically is a business line which comprises of two very distinct set of product lines One is the appliances part of kitchen business, which includes like kitchen and home appliances. The key subcategories here would be typically water purifiers, air purifiers, vacuum cleaners, juicer, mixer, grinders, fan, geysers, like almost all the electronic appliances which a person will use within his kitchen or at home. The second part of the kitchen business is the kitchen and dining products, which typically will be products like pressure cookers, gas stoves, kitchen utensils, racks, etc., which you use. The category is extremely relevant from a seasonal purchase perspective as well as a gifting purchase perspective, and typically spikes nearly 8 times versus the non-event days which we see. Okay, so we'll devote the next 10 minutes to discuss the key subcategories within kitchen and see how we should be going ahead and planning for the upcoming event season. I'll start with the small appliances part of the business. Within small appliances, the key product lines or the products which spike the most are typically during the Diwali season are typically irons, which is again a bit of a seasonal but typically household product. But we have seen that the spike is led on two factors. One is due to the spike driven by the events and high number of people visiting. Second, it is also a very good gifting proposition within a particular set of budget. Okay, so the irons which spike here are dry irons, steam iron, and heavyweight irons. These are the three major subcategories here. And the product price point which we typically look at is starting from 199 and going upwards till 999. The key brands within the iron space are Philips, Bajaj, and Havells. And the projected spike which we see from the normal days is close to 8 times the overall business which we do. Okay, moving on to the next segment, which is flat grills. Flat grills are predominantly induction cooktops and radiant cooktops. This subcategory has been spiking fairly high even during the year this year, where we have grown by more than like 120% year on year. The specific reason for that spike is basically due to a large amount of people requiring this as part of their work from home, increased work from home scenarios right now. And we expect the spike to continue. Again, under this, there are different product line, product specifications, which we will probably discuss in the slide to come. But the ASPs, which we look at an entry price point level, starts from 999 and goes till 1699. And if we are looking at premium propositions within this space, then it goes to till 2200. Okay, apart from like your normal brands like Philips, Prestige and all, we have also seen a good play from the regional brands which have recently come up. So this could be a very good proposition to add to your existing selection within kitchen appliances. Moving on, again, I'll club blender and juicer both. Both are basically predominantly products used for convenience in kitchen. We have again, as I said, we have seen huge spikes, huge multifold growth in the last 1 year, predominantly due to the increased need of these products in the kitchen space due to more people working from home. Right, we are seeing more selection increase, and we would expect, like at least in the blender part of the business, that if we are dealing with key brands like Morphy, Richards, Boss, Kent, you will see a good spike there. Okay, next slide, please. Yeah, so. Again, what I'll do is I'll devote like 2 minutes to discuss the two key subcategories and the products which customers typically are looking in. One is the mixer grinder part of the business. until last year, the mixer grinder part of the business was predominantly in a range where less than 600 watt mixer grinders used to contribute to the majority part of the business. There has been a substantiated change in terms of customer preferences, and we have seen like close to like 57% of the demand is now coming for mixer grinders greater than 600 watt, with 600 to 750 being the predominant wattage preferred by the customers. Again, within this segment, if you have a private label of your own, you can basically target these two wattages in terms of putting forward a new product launch. In case you deal in brands like Philips, Prestige, Preeti, these are the models and the wattage which you should be definitely looking at. Okay, moving to induction cooktops. As I said, the almost a similar trend to mixer grinders. We have seen a category shift where people are now preferring like fully loaded models with higher power. Here also there has been a significant shift of upward of more than 60% towards the 1800 watt plus models, and this is again due to the increased demand and usage which we have seen. Both these subcategories, mixer grinders and induction cooktops, have grown like upwards of 100% year on year, and we expect them to contribute a lot during the upcoming sales season as well. Yeah, next slide please. Yeah, this is here we like to discuss about the seasonal part of the business, which is extremely seasonal for kitchen and home appliances, to be specific. The first category which I'll take, which I'll discuss, is about heaters. Heaters, predominantly the season starts from September, picks up steam in October and November, and continues till January. So this is basically a season where within the 5 months, the entire 70 to 75% of the entire subcategory business is done. Within heaters, we have seen like multiple subcategories, which multiple product lines which have come up. One is geysers. Geysers also can be like basically instant water heaters and your traditional geysers. The second is your immersion rods, which are basically low ASP items and can cater to the common usage of people in the tier 3 and tier 4 towns. So what we are looking at here is that at an instant water heater, the ASP should be somewhere from $16.99 to $24.99, depending upon their capacity as well as their wattage. Same for storage water heaters. The typical capacities which work really well are 25 liters and 15 liters. Within immersion rods, the key price points which we see start from $299 upwards of $999. And here we see a lot of well-known brands like Crompton, Bajaj, Havells dominating the market, but also there is a equal space for regional brands which have come up and are doing good amount of business. So in case you have a private label of your own, this is the right time to focus on this category and scale up your business. The second part of the seasonal category is your OFR and room heaters. Again, this is very, very seasonal, predominantly for the north part of the country, where we see a huge demand. The top brands are Orpet, Morphy Richards and Havells. Fans and stabilizers and inverters are the other key subcategories which typically perform well during the events. If we can move to the next slide, and the next speaker, Anjali, will take it up.
Malvika, before Anjali takes it further, can we just do a quick check with everybody if they can hear us, and if, because I see one quick question in the chat window, why is this session not started yet? So that I just wanted to check if this is one of a case or like people can hear us or not.
it's a one of a case. I think not many of them have sent out a question saying that they cannot hear. That it might be that there's an internet issues going on. Anybody sure. who's having any tech issues can quit and rejoin, and they will be able to hear us.
Cool. Thanks. Yeah, Anjali, please go on.
Thank you, Shikesh. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to all. So I'll take you through the kitchen and dining segment of kitchen category. So kitchen and dining comprises of major seven categories, which include your cookware, tableware, glassware, drinkware, kitchen storage, bakeware, and tools and gadgets. So from Diwali point of view, kitchen and dining is one of the most important category because it spiked a lot because of all traditional or religious or gifting reasons. So what I'll do is I'll just quickly take you through a couple of major categories which spiked quite a lot during Diwali. So we'll start with cookware. Cookware is the biggest category in K&D, kitchen and dining. It comprises of products like your pots and pans, karai and woks, your frying pans, tawa, your pressure cookers, etc. And also your gas stoves and burners, which I think is not mentioned over here, but yes. So all these subcategories, they spike a lot during Diwali, and the major ASPs where we have seen the spike, the maximum spike is in case of pots and pans, it's between 500 to 1,500. 500 being ASP for all the homegrown brands and some of the, lower ASP brands like the Pigeon, etc., Nylon and all those, brands. And 1500 being an ASP, segment for your premium brands like your Prestige, Hawkins, etc. In case of karai, we see highest, sell through in a range of 300 to 800. Similarly, for cooker, it is between 2000 to 5000. So in case of cookware, as we all know, the top brands include your Hawkins, Nylon, Pigeon, Prestige, etc. And there are many private label brands which have come up and are doing really well. Am I audible if somebody can?
Yes, Anjali, you are.
Okay, Rishikesh, can we move to the previous slide, please? Yeah, thank you. The previous one. Thank you. So in this particular subcategory, this particular ASP range, we expect a Diwali spike of around 10x, which sounds very high, but actually this is a spike which we really see during Diwali happening. Apart from that, in cookware specifically, we are seeing a lot of uptake and a lot of spike in combos. For all the pots and pans or cooker combos, which is a 2-liter, 3-liter and 5-liter combo, or even with the small appliances and cookware combos. So for example, induction cooker with induction cooktop with your induction based kadhai or tawa or pan. So these are some of the product types which sells a lot, and if you go to Amazon page, you will always find that these are mostly the best sellers. So combos is one space that somebody really wants to, see a lot of goodness. This is one space where one can actually try and, have stocks and inventories. The next subcategory that I have taken is bakeware. Bakeware is comparatively smaller, but the reason why we have included this particular subcategory is we have seen an increase in bakeware share significantly post the lockdown last year. So there was probably people started baking as a, interest or as a hobby, and then now it has become a habit for them. And now we see there is a consistent spike in bakeware subcategory in spite of, lockdown being eased up and everything happening. Bakeware is one subcategory where we have not seen any degrowth or, drop in this spike. So bakeware is majorly dominated by your private label or homegrown brands. Now we are seeing some of the head brands like Hawkins, Wonderchef, etc. coming into the space. But till now, it is being dominated by all the private label brands and private label sellers who are doing phenomenal in this particular category. So bakeware comprises of all your molds and tins, bakeware sets, bakeware accessories, even, you know, the presentation that you do after making cakes and all. That is also something which is seeing a lot of spike, and people are, you know, very interested to buy that particular, you know, product type as well. So if we talk about the ASP in molds, we see highest sell-through happening between a range of $199 to $799, though it's a, you know, significant, you know, range, I would say. However, having said that, $199 and $799 would also depend on the product type. So silicone, etc., is something which we are seeing, you know, increasingly being, you know, sold on Amazon. Similarly, we have aluminium molds, we have, you know, different product type like carbon coating molds and all. So again, the ASP would differ with each material type. So yeah, so that is where the range is. Apart from that, we have mixing bowls, which starts from $500 to $999, where there is a maximum of take, and mixing bowls also, if there is a set of two or three, that sells the maximum. Again, in case of bigware sets also are the same thing. The range is between $499 or, you know, $500 to $1599. The top brands, as I mentioned, one of the, you know, homegrown brand is Alda, and apart from that, there are other seller brands also. So we again expect a 5x Diwali spike in this subcategory. Yeah, so this would be a very, very, interesting space to be in for the sellers who actually want to venture into K&D during Diwali. Can we move to the next slide, please? So I'll just quickly take two particular subcategories which are very, very important from Diwali point of view. Cooktops being one, because cooktop being very a high ASP category, and the maximum sell-through happens during Diwali in this particular subcategory. We have two burners, three burners, four burners, and now we have seen hobs which are being sold a lot on the platform. So three burner obviously is having the highest share, which is almost 43%. But interestingly, what we have seen is over last year, we have seen an increased sales share of four burner and hobs, and the share of three burner has reduced, which used to be around 50% till last year or till last 2019. But people have now kind of started picking up four burners and hobs. So therefore, we have seen an increased uptake in these two segments in case of cooktops. So during Diwali, we are expecting, so this 1.5x growth seems a little lesser. So we are expecting at least 2.2 to 2.3x growth in case of cooktops at an overall level. In case of burner price point also, we see maximum sales happening within a price point of around 2000 to 2500 ASP, where we are expecting around 1.7x growth. From 500 to 1000, it is written 100, but the correct number is 1000 ASP. So from 500 to 1000, which are usually your single burner or two burner cooktops, there also we see a good spike happening during Diwali. So these two price points are something we should be looking at. Apart from that, we are seeing, so the previous Diwali, previous sale events also, we have seen a good uptake in the opening price point burners. For example, 999 or 1999 for a, three burner and an automated burner, something like that. It's something which sells quite a lot, and there's a huge spike that is seen in that particular price point and that particular product type. So in case anybody is dealing into burners, please, they should make a note of this as well. We'll go to pots and pans. Pots and pans is a part of cookware again, and this is again one of the highest selling, highest sell-through subcategory during Diwali. The maximum, material type that gets sold in pots and pans is aluminium and nonstick. However, having said that, this year, like three burner, we have seen a drop. In case of aluminium and nonstick also, we have seen a significant drop, and the share has been taken by your stainless steel, cast iron, hard anodized, etc. So in case of stainless steel, we have seen a 3x growth, and triply growth is 2.8x over the 2019 number, basically. In case of pressure cooker also, hard anodized, we have seen a growth of around 3.2x, and stainless steel again, there is a 1.6x growth. And there is a 2-liter, 3-liter, 5-liter combo, as I've mentioned earlier, is something which is being preferred by the customers. So yeah, this was these are some of the insights from kitchen and dining subcategory. I think we can move to next slide and next speaker. Thank you so much.
Hi everyone, good evening. Welcome to the webinar. My name is Abhishek. I take care of home improvement business at Amazon. I've been taking this category, taking care of this category for last 3 years, and it will be my third Diwali. So just to give you a context, home improvement comprises of products which are required to build, maintain, or operate any house. So this is a broad definition. It has a range of categories. Some of the prominent ones which we will talk about here, especially from Diwali point of view. The most important category from GMS and customer interest backwards is bath hardware. And in bath hardware, the products which are most sought after among customers include your all the accessories which you see in bathroom, like towel rack, soap holders, sinks, faucets. These are some of the popular product types. Here in this space, there's a fair balance between branded players as well as private labels. And the price range varies from 250 to 1750. That is the preferred favorite price point. For these different type of products, the price point varies. For example, health faucet, typically customers look for, if it is a private label, 450, 500. And if it is a branded selection, customer go look buy product worth of 650, 700. Similarly, towel racks, 18 inch is the preferred one, stainless steel material. That is also one of the most important product types. After towel rack and faucets, another important category here, and especially which is emerging in last 1-2 years, is that shower filters. So basically it removes hardness from the water, and it is very exciting product. These products typically cost you somewhere from 1500 to 2000 rupee. And they are also an opportunity to engage with customers because they need this cartridge refill throughout the journey. So you have an option to, along with selling this product, you can also sell the accessories. So these are some of the important product types in bath hardware. The entire month spike I have given, we can expect close to 1.5, 1.7x, but during the first 5 days of the event, when you know there's a maximum traffic customer demand, we expect this category to see 5 to 6 times business, bring business 5 to 6 times than the regular day. And if you have any question, please feel free to ask, type in the chat window. Then one more product which I would like to mention along with bath hardware itself, though it's not part of bath hardware, but it is related kitchen hardware. So that is kitchen sink. So here in kitchen sink also, we see typically stainless steel 304 material is very popular among customers. And the price range, which is the most sought after, varies from 3100, 3200, 2500, in that range. So that is also a very interesting popular product type. This space is largely dominated by private labels. So if you are not a seller dealing in these products, maybe you can source it. I've shared the preferred price points with you, and I've shared the expected spike with you. But if you are already dealing in this product, I request you to send it to full Amazon for FCs, or if you have Flex, inbound, written Flex, because these categories, typically the products which are in FBA fulfillment channel, they have higher share of business and they tend to show higher sales. You run deals like configure lightning deals and you will get good response in this. A second very exciting and important category is wallpaper. Especially it has become a emerging subcategories post-COVID. Now here there are two types of products. One is that printed wallpapers, which you see in the on your screen. And the second one, the regular 3D one, the plain white color one. So both these products are doing phenomenally well. The good thing about these products are that people tend to buy it in multiple units. They don't buy one unit usually. And that kind of offsets for the shipping cost involved because these being a low ASP products. So you have some cushion there. The printed in printed wallpapers, the most preferred dimension among customer is 45 centimeter into 500 centimeter. And in the 3D wallpaper, that is all these are you know, self-adhesives. So you can do it at your home. Customers can do it at their home. They don't need any professional help or anything. And the preferred one price point for the 3D wallpapers is 17 to 77 centimeter, which is 5.8 square feet. Again, this category for the entire 1 month period, I estimate the spike will be close to 1.8 to 2 times over a regular month. And first 5-6 days, again, the spike will be in the tune of 6 times of the regular business days. The preferred price point for this product is ₹199-249. You see there, if the customers generally club their products and the order size increases to 1100-1200. The third important category is security system, and there are two major product types under this category. One is safes, which is also very important from Diwali point of view. In safes, usually you have some big brands operating there like Godrej, Yale, that are already there, and the preferred price point among customers is like 4,800, 5,000. But we also see customers going for cheaper alternative. Those are non-branded, but they typically price between 1,800 to 2,200. So that is one category. And then you have these biometric devices. Here, this Mantra and Safran Morpho, these products are typically used for, you know, biometric verification, KYC thing. So these are some of the very interesting products. These are in high demand. Malvika, can we move to next slide, please? Okay, this is the second and the last slide in home improvement. Now the next category is cord and power management. So cord and power management includes all the products like, you know, extension boards, switches, wires, the things which is used at home. And here again, this is mostly dominated by brands like Anker, Cisco, GM, Havels, Polycap. So these are some of the preferred products and preferred brands in this space. The typical preferred price point varies from ₹250 to 500. And again, during the entire month, we expect close to 1.6 to 1.7 times of business. Next category being power tools. So here, power tools are basically those products which customers and customers, you know, like to use at their home, which they can use themselves. They don't need any professional for that. So these includes your drill kit, etc., glue guns and pliers, all these things. So typically this space is dominated by brands like Bosch, Black & Decker. But again, we have seen some of the private labels also making their way and doing good in this category. And the preferred price point, if we talk about this drill set, the entire kit, the preferred, the most popular price point is somewhere 3,000 to 3,500. But then we also see the lower end products like plier, testers, which come in the range of 250, and this 31-in-1 drill set. So these are low ASP products are also very popular, but then again, those are not branded selection. So in this space, we see a spike close to 1.8 times during the regular month. And the last category, and which has been one of the fastest growing category despite being of huge size this year, is ladders. It has done phenomenally well. It's growing at triple digit rate. And in ladders, mostly there are two major type of ladders. The dominant one being step ladders, and then you have telescopic ladders. Both are growing. In step ladders, the most popular being 5-step and 4-step. And here the material is mostly of the two type, aluminum and steel. These are the ones preferred by customers. Again, the preferred price for this type of product, 5-step, 6-step ladders, is between 2,000 to 2,800. That will be the range. Telescopic LiDAR is slightly more expensive, but this space is largely dominated by private labels. So this was about ladders, and we expect this category to grow, you know, do almost 3 times business of a regular month in this Diwali. And first 5 days, I estimate the growth to be somewhere close to 6 to 7x. And the next and the last product type which I'd like to talk about is like your locks and hardware, other hardwares. So these are mostly your locks and hydraulic locks and latches, hooks that customers use at home. There again also there are dominant brands like Godrej, etc., but then there are large number of private labels that for this hooks, and the typical price point for this product type is ₹250. So these were some of the most popular and sought after products in home improvement, which we are relying heavily on coming Diwali, and we expect to see a good response there. If you already deal in these products, please configure lightning deals at your end, and you will definitely gain from the increasing customer demand. Thank you.
Hi everyone, thanks for that, Abhishek. Hi, this is Archit. I take care of the sports category at Amazon. I'll be taking you through the overview of sports and how we expect it to grow over Diwali. Can we move to the first slide? Yeah, so to give you a quick overview of sports is basically divided into 4 or 5 different subcategories, you can say. One is your cardio subcategory, or the cardio cohort, which consists of your treadmills, exercise bikes, ellipticals, rowers. Then there would be weights, benches, etc. The third part would be your cycling, which includes both your adult cycles, kid cycles, accessories and all. And then there would be core sports, which include your cricket, badminton, table tennis and all the other sports which are there. So I'll go one by one. So starting with treadmills. So treadmills right now contributes maximum to the sports category. It is into different type of models, both manual and auto models come right now and are available on Amazon.in. Both of these models actually are dominated by private players right now. We don't have a major head brand which is dominating the market, and we do expect this category to keep growing. It has shown multifold growth over last year, and the average price point that we see where the most of the demand comes is around 15,000 to 20,000 range, where a treadmill of 1.5 to 2H horsepower comes up. So this actually, this category we expect it to spike approximately 8x. Almost all the cardio subcategories, we expect them to spike 6 to 8x in the Diwali season. So this is one of the top subcategories, since it is also very high in its price point as well. Hence, if you have these products, these should give very additional goodness to your products if you put them on deals. Coming on to exercise bike. Exercise bikes are basically can be divided into both domestic as well as imported bikes. The domestic bikes are in the range of 5,000 to 8,000, whereas the imported ones are upwards of 15,000 right now. Similar to treadmills, it doesn't have any hero player or any significant head brand which is dominating and is dealt into with multiple private labels. We have seen different private labels coming into picture and doing well over the year. Similarly, moving on, there is another cardio equipment, which is ellipticals, which also we expect to do similar growth, similar trajectory, follow similar trajectory like exercise bikes and treadmills. Ellipticals is one part where right now we don't have a major player dominating at all, not neither a private label nor a head brand. And I believe if you have an elliptical product available with you, listing it and giving it, putting it on deal will give you a lot of goodness in your business. Moving on to cycles. Cycles are the second most sought after category in Amazon, in sports at Amazon. Cycles are actually always in the top search keywords at Amazon, and hence they will always be featuring and have always been growing consistently over the past years. And now with the ease of COVID restrictions, the category has seen 140% to 135% growth over the last 3 months. Cycles include both your geared as well as non-geared cycles. The typical range for geared cycles is 5,000, non-geared cycles is 5,000 to 8,000. And the typical range of non-geared cycles, of geared cycles is around 10,000 to 20,000 rupees. We do have a lot of private labels available for the 3P side of market. And the top brands include Hero, Hercules, Cross, Cosmic, Firefox, and then there are multiple seller brands as well. So we expect this category to grow at least 4.5x. Similar to Kit Cycle is a small category right now, and it has been growing over the past year due to increase in demand of cycles through as the COVID restriction has been opening up. Same for there is no major brand available right now for Kit Cycle, and hence for sellers who have the Kit Cycle selection can dominate this market once they enter it. So we do expect the Kit Cycles also to spike at least 5x during Diwali, since it can also be used as a gifting selection for the kids over the period of Diwali. Can we move to next slide? So like it's told, the second part is your core sports. Core sports consists of cricket, badminton, skating and other sports as well, but badminton, cricket and skating are the major part of or the major part of the core sports category. In badminton, we have the top brands Yonex, Costco and Leiling. Where Costco is the second largest for badminton, and Yonex is the largest in the badminton category. For badminton category, instead of selling a single badminton, we should look at selling a combo of badminton as well as shuttlecocks, since those actually cater more demand on the platform. We expect around 4.5x spike in Diwali in Diwali for this category. Cricket bats are actually divided into your plastic bats and then your wood or imported wood bats. Then there are cricket kits, helmets and bags, etc. Similar to badminton, cricket kits and cricket combos actually gain more demand rather than a single cricket bat which is listed. Hence, you should look at creating combos for crickets as well, which should give you a higher demand share. Typical ASP range for one single bat is around 500, and then for the imported range, it goes upwards of 6,000 as well. For kits though, cricket kit, it ranges from 2,000 to 10,000 usually. The top brands include SG, SS, GM and MRF. Skating is one category which is currently having just a single player which is dominating, which is a private brand named Jaspo. Other than that, we don't have any heavy dominance in skating, hence this could be a good category to enter into and capture market share. We also expect it to grow around 3.5x during Diwali. This includes both your inline skates, roller skates and skates accessories. Can you go to the next slide? Yeah, so elliptical I have already explained. So the next category would be your dumbbells and weights and home gyms. I will combine it together with fitness accessories, as all these are sort of a home gym product, which have seen a significant jump across the subcategories and during the last year due to COVID restrictions. To give you just a quick example, yoga mats and yoga tubes and these fitness bands have grown more than 250% year on year. And dumbbells and weights have also seen upwards of 150% growth in the last year. Similar to how the other categories have been performing, these should also perform well, and we expect at least 3x growth in these categories. These are mostly self-explanatory, but where there is a gap in the selection, we can look at if you have selection of the rubber dumbbells or the rubber plates, since that is not heavily present on the platform, and you can use that white space to capture that market, to capture that demand. Similarly for badminton, cricket and all those things, these also sell in combos better instead of individual dumbbells or individual products. You should create combos for these as well, and the combos range from anywhere from 1000 to 1500 for dumbbells and home gyms, and for fitness accessories it ranges from 250 to 2500. The final subcategory is your sports clothing and accessories. These includes your sports shoes, sports clothes, your camping and bags, tents, lighters, trophies, etc. All these are included in this this category. We have, over the period of 2021 specifically, we have seen a lot of growth in sports shoes and sports clothes. This we expect specifically to grow at least greater than 5x, but on the overall specific subcategory we should see a 5x spike. The top brands in these are still heavy brands which are Puma, Reebok and Adidas, but the private players have also started kicking in, and we expect growth in those brands as well. Hence these are basically the top subcategories that you should focus on for Diwali, where we see a growth more than 4x to 5x across during Diwali. The price points are mentioned in these slides, and this should help you to gain market share accordingly. If you have any questions, you can just put them in the chat and I'll be happy to take them up. I think that's all. I don't think there is another category left. Rushikesh, over to you.
So we have thanks for patiently listening in. So we have come to a conclusion on the category bit. I'll just take 2 minutes to let you all know about what are the other options around customer experience and affordability which we can drive and give a good customer experience to our valued customers. Specifically from the event standpoint, I would like to highlight 2 things. One is the no-cost EMI program, where a customer, where you can opt in for no-cost EMI for your ASINs, and this is typically applicable for products with a selling price which is greater than 3000 rupees. Here you can curate your no cost EMI offers in multiple ranges, like 3 months, 6 months, 9 months tenure, and you can also give it across key banks, maybe the SBI, HDFC and all. That is something which you can select. For more details, you can search on the Seller Central help page, and you will get a help page for no cost EMI, which details on how to go ahead and activate no cost EMI for your products. The second thing is about seller powered coupons. This is something which you would have already known about it, but again, this is a very useful tool to showcase and run offers for your selection. This is basically a sell tool where only once the customer buys it, then only you pass on the discount to the customers. another important thing which comes as a differentiating factor for your selection is speed. Basically, how quickly you are able to deliver your product to the customer who is ordering it. The idea around this is the faster we deliver, the better is the conversion and the better is the post-sales experience for the customer as well. So here, while I am assuming that most of you would know how Amazon is replicated, has warehouses across multiple states, I would encourage you to go ahead and see if you can replicate your stocks to multiple states so as to provide next day or the same day delivery to the customers. Basically, from an upcoming event standpoint, these three things, no cost EMI, seller powered coupons and speed, are more key important levers, and you should go ahead and try and ensure that you are up to, you are giving the best experience to the customer. Yeah, Rishikesh, this is what I had. Over back to you.
Thanks, Akshay. So in continuation with what Akshay said about speed, right? I have shared one link on the chat window. This is about the rework program, which is currently live on inverting your material into FCs. Please go through the details, and if you can double your inventory from 22nd August to 22nd September, then there is some 95% off on the storage fee and all. The details are there in that link. Please use this, and this is a way to push you to invert more into FCs, because this is what is going to help you to increase your sales as well. Your conversion will increase, as Akshay said. Right. So that's all we had. On one final note, I would say ki, one important thing, most important thing, will be having inventory in place. So, and then having it in FBA and running sponsored ads on the ASINs which you think are selling best for you. Right. And anything and everything which will be in stock will sell, because this is a Diwali time, right? So let's focus on this, having the ASINs in stock first and running proper sponsored ads on them. That's all we have for this session. Thank you for being patient and listening to us. I don't see any question pending to be answered specific to category. So this session will be shared with you. A recording will be shared with you over mail. Please wait for that, mostly by end of the day or tomorrow this will be shared with you, so you can re-go through it and check whatever information that you might have missed upon. Correct. So that's all. Thanks for joining here, and wish you a very happy Diwali in advance, and let's have a great Diwali season ahead. Thank you. Bye.